course, I'm so delighted to welcome all of you to this evening. Yes, it is that time of the year where we all look forward to the annual Crossword Book Awards, the pioneering, the prestigious book awards that recognize the best writing in our country. I now present the award of the popular category of the 17th Crossword Book Award, Popular Award for Fiction. As I invite on stage once again, Mr. Rajiv Suri, Vice Chairman, Crossword Bookstores and Managing Director and CEO, Shop a Stop, to tell us who the winner is.
Winner of the Popular Award for Fiction, Pyjamas Are for Giving, by Twinkle Khanna.
Crossword for this award. I may not deserve it, but I didn't deserve a name like Twinkle either. Not that the names I've come up with after that have been any better, Mrs. Funny Bones and even Baba Twink Dev. Now I think I have to coin yet another moniker, if for nothing else than to say that I'm following in the path of Susan Sontag, who said that a writer has to be four people: a nut, a moron, a stylist, and a critic. Now, a nut comes easy to me. It's the part that dreams up all these ideas and then puts this unfiltered nonsense or regurgitates it onto paper, which masquerades as my first draft. A moron. I strongly believe in the power of being a moron. I wrote about it last week. The people who think about their stupidity are often the most intelligent, because it is only the truly dumb who are convinced of their smartness. The ones who are secretly wondering if they are idiots are the ones who know that there is so much to know that they clearly don't know enough. If you have understood this sentence, then you're clearly a moron like me, which is also a prime example of an oxymoron. Yeah, well, I write for a living, so. Stylist is, I guess, the difference between using a word like regurgitate instead of just saying vomit. And critic, this is the most important part, because writers need to have an inflated sense of self-worth while they're writing, to feel that what they're saying is worthy of someone else's attention. And then they have to have the ability to put that ego aside, look at that work objectively, and yes, all of us, listen to your editor, take their suggestions, incorporate them, because I think that is the most important thing a writer needs to do. If I'm standing here, it's because of three writers, three editors who molded me. My first, Saritha Tanwar at DNA, Neelam Raj, who makes sure that my copy is as sharp as it could be in Times of India, and also that I don't write myself into having mochas outside my house every second Sunday. And of course, Chiki Sarkar, the editor and publisher of this book, who cut 10,000 words out of my manuscript and I wanted to stab her in the bloody heart. But in hindsight, it was good, because for some odd reason, I decided that I want to throw in as many metaphors as there are pages, which would have been disastrous. So technically, this is her award as much as it is mine, and I thank you on our behalf.
Fantastic. Mrs. Funny Bones, thank you so much. Many congratulations. That acceptance speech was a crash course for me on how to be the most successful writers of our country. Let me invite on stage Mr. Rajiv Suri, Vice Chairman, Crossword Bookstores Limited, and Managing Director and CEO, Shoppers Stop Limited, to share his thoughts with us here this evening. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Suri.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to India's leading literary award that celebrates the work of Indian authors who have left an impact on our thinking. The Crossword Books Award felicitates intelligent and unpretentious storytelling. It gives a platform for new voices to be heard, providing thus an equal opportunity to showcase the rich diversity in India's literary space. Since its inception 17 years ago, Crossword Book Awards has been the torchbearer and has evolved as a platform to source hidden as well as popular literary gems by Indian authors. In a time where opinions and thoughts are varied, and where the world is indeed your oyster, the wide range of categories of Crossword Book Awards helps bring forth admiration and recognition to an array of versatile subjects that hold the power to inspire, change, relate, and motivate the society. It's an honor to be present amongst such a distinguished audience of creative minds that have the ability to shape and influence our communities. The Crossword Group holds a special place for us at Shopper Stop with a long-standing association that aims to provide a delightful shopping experience every time, every day. With a strength of 80 stores across the country, Crossword is the largest chain of bookstores in India and amongst the top 10 globally. A wide portfolio of books, movies, music, toys, and stationery, Crossword is the definitive place for those who seek information, knowledge, or just the pleasure of reading. As the old adage goes, a man who reads is a man who knows. Reading enlightens the mind in more ways than we can elaborate. There is only gratitude towards all those who keep the literary art alive and thriving. I wish all the participating authors the very best and look forward to many more inspirational works. Thank you to the esteemed jury for giving us your time. We really, really appreciate that. Thank you to the Crossword team and our partners behind the scene in putting together this event. Thank you to our participating authors who have, and I'm sure who will continue to weave magic through their immersive storytelling. And thank you to the publishers who have given them the wings in bringing their work to life. I wish you all a wonderful evening and welcome to the 17th Crossword Book Awards. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Mr. Suri. And now I'd like to request Director Crossword Book Awards, Ms. Himali Sodhi, to please join me on stage and to say a few words. Let's welcome all with a warm round of applause, everyone.
Good evening, and thank you for joining us. It's a great feeling for us to be hosting the 17th Crossword Book Awards at a place that we love. The Crossword Kemp's Corner Bookstore, which is something of an iconic venue for book lovers. Some of our happiest memories have to do with visiting a bookstore, browsing through the new arrivals and old favorites, discovering new writers, and going home with an armful of wonderful books, only to return shortly for more. For many of us, the Crossword Kemp's Corner store is associated with many such memories. So, it is fitting that, as we step into a new phase of this much-loved bookstore, we return to the place where it all started, for the 2020 edition of the Crossword Book Awards. A great deal has happened since the first Crossword Book Awards were presented nearly two decades ago. Times have changed, and the world of books has changed somewhat as well. What hasn't changed, though, is the author's passion for writing books, the publisher's excitement in publishing them, the retailer's interest in showcasing and selling them, and the reader's fascination with reading them. The Crossword Awards celebrates this entire cycle of reading and writing that enthuses and enriches us. Through 17 editions of the Crossword Book Awards, Crossword has renewed its unwavering commitment to recognize and reward the best and most popular writing that comes out of India every year. Over the years, we've added more categories to the awards to reflect the vibrance, the diversity, and the sheer brilliance of writing across genres. We now present jury awards in four categories: fiction, Indian language translation, non-fiction, and children's writing. And the popular awards, judged by an open voting system, in six categories: fiction, non-fiction, business and management, biography, health and fitness, and children's. I would like to thank a wonderful jury, 12 highly accomplished, brilliant individuals who came together to read through and discuss hundreds of books, to arrive first at a shortlist and then at a winner for each of the four jury awards. And I'd also like to thank the followers of the Crossword Awards for engaging with the popular awards and making their vote count in the 6 popular categories. I'd also like to congratulate all the writers and publishers, not just the winners of those shortlisted, but all those who continue to write and publish books, carrying forward the legacy of reading. Thank you all for being here this evening, and we will now move on to the award presentations.
Note, let's begin and honor the most outstanding voices in Indian literature across diverse genres at the 17th Crossword Book Awards. We will be presenting the awards in the popular category, the awards which are determined by a voting system followed by the jury awards. This year again, we have 6 categories under the popular awards, namely business and management, health and fitness, non-fiction, children, fiction, and biography. In each category, there are 5 shortlisted books, and our first category is one that the business heads in our team find particularly inspiring. The shortlist includes Raghuram Rajan discussing the markets, Chandramali Venkatesan telling us how to get better at getting better, Anil Lamba teaching us how to flirt with stocks, Anju Sharma, an IAS officer, revealing her journey from wealth to wisdom, and last but of course not the least, Indraneel Chakraborty, unlocking the secrets to business storytelling. I mean, if this lineup doesn't inspire us, then what will? As you might have guessed already, the first popular award this evening at the 17th Crossword Book Award is Business and Management. Let's take a look at the nominees. Let's welcome our presenters also, ladies and gentlemen, with a warm round of applause.
Still.
The winner of the popular award for business and management, Corporate Monk, A Journey from Wealth to Wisdom.
It's a great honor for the first time writer like me. First thing that I would like to do is to thank the right place for giving an opportunity to a first-time writer. And struggling writers would know how difficult it is for the first-time writer without having a celebrity tag to strike at their first book. Of course, this is my second book. It is as good as my first book in the popular domain. So a lot of credit goes to Anupji, Rinki, who've been talking to me, and of course Manish Purohit of the Writers Upfront, and who've really helped me in developing this book and making this book reach this place. Corporate Monk is not just a book. It's the purpose of my life. Having led a very spiritually dumb life for something like 45 years, I realized some changes happened that in my life. And I realized that this is not the life I should be leading. There is something much, much, much more to it. And that is what turned me towards spirituality and spiritual intelligence. You will not believe that the research that I'm doing as a part of my PhD has thrown the results that in the age group of 20 to 30, more than 50% corporate managers are burnt out. And if you see their spiritual intelligence level, it is the lowest. It's unfortunate that what the college doesn't teach us, the life teaches us. And it is the school of life that teaches us, which we lack in the school of the college, or the school, the proper education. My mission in life is to bring spiritual intelligence in the institutions, in the B schools that are grooming the managers of the coming age, but forgetting that other than leadership, which has 2 dimensions, that is the people and the work, there is a 3rd dimension to it, your own self, which is guided by spiritual intelligence and the spiritual quotient. Thank you all. Thank you for giving me this opportunity. Thanks once again.
And many congratulations to you.
And a big thanks to my family, who always encouraged me into this. My husband and my daughter are here. My son are here. So thanks a lot to them and all my friends who have made this a success. Thank you.
I think there's somebody with a real acute sense of irony who chose me. I don't know if Uma is trying to give me a message. I'll buy all 5 books. the winner of the popular award for health and fitness, Skin Rules, by Dr. Jayshree.
And ladies, do you have any questions on skins? No? No. Ma'am, go for it.
Go for it. Thank you so much, Team Crossword, for nominating me and for giving me this huge honor. I will say a few thank yous. First to Twinkle for encouraging me right there and saying, you're gonna win. Thank you, Twinkle. Millie and Gurveen, who were my editors, who made sure that I got out of my comfort zone of being a doctor and also started writing. Penguin Random House for believing that I could do something other than just holding syringes and needles. All those who've bought the books, because if you wouldn't buy, Crossword wouldn't know who I was and wouldn't have nominated me. And of course, everybody who's voted for me. My family, my husband, he's got my back. Thank you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, I have to tell you that you have to follow certain simple skin rules every day. And because in today's day and age, the skin really rules. So thank you.
Let's move to the next category. The next award is the 17th Crossword Book Award for Popular Award for Nonfiction. Let's take a look at the nominees. And to present this award, I'd like to invite on stage producer and presenter of India's biggest breakfast radio show, Good Morning Mumbai, on 94.3 Radio 1. We all know him as Rishi K.
Life's Amazing Secrets, How to Find Balance and Purpose in Your Life, by Shridhar Gopalas.
Let's hear it for him, ladies and gentlemen, once again.
This evening, I want to express my deep gratitude firstly to all our online followers and supporters, because I don't think I would have gotten an opportunity to write a book if people wouldn't have known me online. So I'm very, very grateful to every like, share, comment on all the online platforms. Because of all the followers is what I received this opportunity to write. I definitely want to express my sincerest gratitude to Penguin Random House and the team at Penguin Random House for giving me this opportunity to write Life's Amazing Secrets. My sincere gratitude to our team who's been behind all of this. Thanks to Vinay Raniga, my friend in London, who's been with me in this journey for editing Life's Amazing Secrets. My gratitude to my family, my guru, and of course, my sincerest gratitude to all the readers. What is an author without the reader, right? So my gratitude to all the readers for their support by picking up this book, reading it, and making what it is today. And certainly, thanks to all those who voted for Life's Amazing Secrets to bring it up here this evening. And thank you all very much.
Winner of the Popular Award for Children's Writing, The Upside Down King.
Woohoo!
Get an award even at this age. It's a great incentive. This award really should go to children, my readers who make me a writer. And it should really go to my grandparents actually. They taught me so much of mythology. Thanks to, there are no video games in those days, or TV, and they taught me so much. And it made a great impact in my life. And whenever I'm down or anything, I'm a human. It's not always I'm, woman of steel. It's I'm a human. I always think of those characters which had difficulties and how they won. And that I want to install in next generation. So thanks to my grandparents and my great readers, of course, Penguin Random House and the entire team, You're always me and the crossword where I always read my book. Thank you once again.
Wow, let's hear it from her. And Sudha ma'am, before I let you go, I just want to give you a big warm hug on behalf of all of us and tell you that although I don't look like it, but what do looks have to do with anything, right? I'm totally set to follow in your footsteps. And sorry, I disagree. You are a woman of steel in a beautiful 6 yards. Sorry. So, ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for her once again. And thank you so much for doing the honors. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to present our first jury award. And I'd like to welcome Mukund Padmanabhan on stage. Please join me, sir.
Yeah, good evening. If I might just say a few words, I think as the introduction made clear, I think it would be an opposite if Arshia or Asad were here to give this away. They've been in the business of translation far longer than I have. I, for one, I think I've read more books in translation over the last couple of months than I have perhaps in many years. And as a jury, we discussed, I think, many of the things that any jury dealing with translations that come from so many languages would. How much weight do we give, how much to the heft of the original work? Do we privilege new voices? And or do we, take the felicity of the prose in the translation into account. And I think that was finally what won the day. And without much ado, the winner of the Indian Language Translation Award is translated by Jayashree Kalathil. It's Diary of a Malayali Madman by Pyjamas.
With me, and I'd like to invite the shortlisted authors to please join us on stage. Let's complete this gathering of Indian literature. All the shortlisted authors, please join us on stage.